The International Labour Organization estimates that children will suffer the worst burden of the global economic and social crisis caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. And as a result, 42 to 66 million children will be pushed into extreme poverty. India has a highly unequal workforce with 90% of the working people engaged in informal work. Tens of thousands have been sent back home by several companies during the lockdown. According to child rights activists, this is adversely affecting the economic environment of poor families, forcing their children to enter the labor force. Consequently, a large section of these children are tied up in bonded labor. Further, the pandemic-induced lockdown also pushed for online education. However, the question is whether such e-learning is accessible to all children throughout India. A large section of the country's population still doesn't have access to internet facilities or smart devices. This was another issue which forced children to drop out from their ongoing education and enter labor force, especially in the rural areas. To find out more, NewsClick visited a few areas in Sivakasi, a town in Viluppuram district of Tamil Nadu, where children are engaged in the fireworks industry.
ஆமாம், இந்த லாக்டவுனில் இங்கே தான் நாங்கள் வேலை பார்க்குறோம். அதிகமாக எங்களால் கொஞ்சம் படிக்க முடியுது, ஆனால் அதிகமாக எங்களால் படிக்க ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ண முடியல. எங்கள் வீட்டில் கொஞ்சம் வருமானம் அவ்வளோவா இல்லை, அதனால் நான் இந்த ஜூன் மாதம் கொஞ்சம் படித்தோம். அப்போ வந்து இந்த ஹாஸ் தொடக்கல, அது பிறகு தான் இந்த மாதிரி அது பிறகு கொஞ்சம் குறைஞ்ச பட்டி ஹாஸ் ஃபேக்ட்ரி திறக்க ஆரம்பித்தாங்க. அதுக்கப்புறம் வந்தோம். ஒரு நாளைக்கு காலையில் 9 மணிக்கு வந்தோன்னா நைட்டு 6 மணி 7 மணி வரை இருக்கும். இல்லை, வாட்ஸ்அப்பில் அனுப்புவாங்க, அது கொஞ்சம் தான் எங்களுக்கு புரியும், மற்றது புரியவே புரியாது. நாங்கள் எப்படி அதுக்காக கான்சன்ட்ரேட்டாக படிக்கிறோம்.
இந்த தொழில் பண்ணுறது வந்து இந்த மணி நாங்கள் லீவில் வந்து வேலை செஞ்சால் தான் எங்களால் இந்த மணி கஷ்டப்படுறோம். வேலை செஞ்சால் தான் எங்களுக்கு இந்த மணி வீட்டில் இருந்தாலும் இது பண்ண முடியும். ஆனால் ஏப்ரல்லேருந்து நாங்கள் இந்த வேலை பார்ப்போம். ஜூன்லேருந்து படிக்க ஆரம்பித்தோம். படிச்சுட்டே தான் இருப்போம். ஞாயிற்றுக்கிழமை நான் படிப்போம், இல்லை டெய்லியும் போய் படிப்போம். இந்த வேலையை செஞ்சுட்டு தான் நாங்கள் படிக்கவே போவோம்.
ஸ்கூல் இருந்தப்போ இங்கே வந்தது அதிகமாக, இப்போ வர்றது அதிகமாக?
இப்போ தான் வர்றாங்க. ஸ்கூல் இருப்போம், மே மாதம் லீவுக்கு மட்டும்தான் நாங்கள் வருவோம், மித்த நாள் வர மாட்டோம். இப்போ வந்து இந்த லீவ் ரொம்ப வரதுனால இங்கே வேலை பார்க்கணும். ஏன்னா அதுக்கு முன்னாடி இவ்வளோ வேலை பார்க்கணும். 10th படிக்கணும்.
சரி, இப்போ உங்கள் வீட்டில் என்ன சூழ்நிலை, எப்படி இருக்காங்க? இந்த கொரோனா காலகட்டத்தில் தான் எப்படி இருந்தாங்க?
அம்மாவுக்கு முன்ன பார்த்ததோட இப்போ வேலை சம்பளம் வந்து கம்மி தான். இப்போ அப்பாவோ அவ்வளவோ கிடையாது, எல்லாருக்கும் கொஞ்சம் கஷ்டப்படுற நிலமையில தான் இருக்கும். நாங்கள் வேலை பார்க்குறது தான் வீட்டில். ஸ்கூல் போனால் தான் படிக்க முடியும். இப்போ பப்ளிக் எப்படி வைக்க போகிறாங்கன்னு தெரியல. நாம ஆனால் நம்ம தயாராகிக்கணும் பப்ளிக்காண்டி. ஆனால் நாங்கள் படிச்சுட்டே தான் இருக்கோம்,
definitely lockdown will have higher impact on children and women, no doubt about it, because the previous disasters they indicate that any damage or any impact that's very higher on girls and women in terms of whether it's a man made or a natural disaster. So we have been telling that it will increase the child labor, it will increase child trafficking, it will increase child marriage. So many child marriages have been stopped during this period. We do not know how many of them gone unnoticed, right? So in terms of child labor, there is a possibility. See, the government closed the schools. It does not mean that they should not engage with the children. The teacher can go to the house and check whether the child is there. Every day, 5 child or 3 child or 2 days a week, they can go and check. They can follow it up. It's not happening. The children are going to work now. We are witnessing from many villages. They are working now. We are trying to support them to get mainstreamed again. But we can see the impact only after the schools are reopened. Now, when you ask them, they'll simply say that, okay, once the schools are reopened, we will definitely go, right? First thing. The second thing, online classes makes the parents into, borrow loan from others. Just imagine, you need a Android mobile. If you need a quality, minimum you need 5,000, right? Whereas already they have been struggling for their food. See, the National Sample Survey Organization clearly said that 51% of almost 52% of the rural families are self-employed. 33% in urban are self-employed. So half of them in rural, you know, more than half of them already lost their income, whereas we are forcing them to go for online education. Where they will go for money? They gave only 1,000 rupees. And of course, appreciate the government, they are giving free rice and dal thing. But is it sufficient for the families? What about the electricity? What about other vegetable and other food materials? Nothing is considered. So that's what we have been asking the government to give monetary support at least for 4 months. Every month 6,000 should be given to the family so that they can come out of the economic shock made due to COVID impact. But it's not considered. Now the children are going to the thing, and online classes, it's really a pressure for the teachers, parents, as well as to the students. There are other methods. So the people suggested they can have a small group. They can discuss. The next day they can meet another small group. They can discuss with all protections, you know, with this distancing. Those things have not been covered due to political reasons, right? So even now what we suggest, the teachers can directly contact their students, either phone, they can make visits to the village and talk to the parents and understand their situation. Otherwise, it will increase the thing. The second thing about the school fees, it's not just online. The school fee, they are not attending the school, but they have to pay the school fees. Whereas they are giving only 30% of the salary to the teachers. Or 40%. I don't know how, from my knowledge, whatever the inquiry I had with the teachers, no teacher is receiving 100% salary from the private schools. Right? Just imagine, there is a fee determination committee. They fix the salary. Right?
Yeah.
Can you see any school displaying this on their board? Just show me one school which displayed, this is the fee determined for different sections, section 7, this month's amount. Can you show me? You cannot. So what the officials are doing then? So if you see, even the average, you know, middle class families, they suffer, they are unable to pay the school fees, and they are forced. Several complaints. To whom they will make? Officials who already knew this thing. Right? So lot of things has to the alternate mechanism has to be considered. Of course, it's a good thing. TV, they are using it. But have you ensured all the cable connection to all the families? Right? Ensure the TV, the working conditions, you know, TV in working condition to all the families. So just like that, you know, these are some of the efforts they are taking here and there. There should be, you know, what we suggest, call the parents in the Zoom meeting. Yeah, there are education experts. Talk to them how we can engage the children during this thing. Government can do that, but they're not willing to do that. So we suggest that they can have a consultation with the educationist experts in the field and what kind of alternative mechanism they can follow it up. So during this COVID, how they can engage the children, everything could have been done, but not done yet. At least now they can think of it. First of all, the role of the teacher should be enhanced. They need to have a direct touch with the children. And also, you know, there are several models. In Andhra, Andhra and West Bengal, they are giving dry rations to the children, right? During lockdown. And they are giving lunch, you know, noon meals. So there will be a link. So not necessarily that they should come and learn, but you know, there will be a link between the school and the children that they can provide noon meal, what is wrong in it. They can maintain the distance, they can take precautions. they can wash their hands, everything, then they can take the food and they can eat at their home or whatever, or they can come and take their rations, whatever allocated for them. And also the teachers should identify the vulnerable children. They know who are all vulnerable. They know the single women-headed families, or you know, single parent. They can say, so that should be monitored. They have to monitor and ensure that all the children, those who are studying in the schools, are still not going to the work. They have to continue. Then we forget about the migrant children, right? The migrant workers from other parts of the country, they came here to work, right? Totally, we forgot about them. In 2019 and 2021, policy note of education department says that in last year, almost 4,000 migrant children of migrant workers have been identified. Among them, around 3,975 were enrolled in the age appropriate classes, right? So among them, almost 50%, nearly 1,700 people are migrant children. 85 volunteers were engaged to teach them in Telugu, Hindi, Bengali, and Oriya. This is a very, very minimum number. In Erode, it is reported that more than 7,000 children of migrant workers are not getting access to the education. Tirupur, Coimbatore, wherever the major pockets of migrant workers, government is having the data, they have to ensure that these children are getting their education in their language. Several measures have been taken by the government, the SSA, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. They brought books from Odisha government and they are doing it. But there are, that's only a very minimum percentage. Most children are out of the school now. And in every village, the government has every panchayat. The government has formed village child protection committees. They need to activate, they need to send the circulars to them. Please ensure that no child from your village is going to the work, because they are local people, village president, village administrative officer, then Anganwadi worker, school teachers, the NGO volunteers, Magalia self-help representative from SKGs, they know. So they have to be assigned the responsibility to monitor the children and vulnerable children. They need to develop plan of action to support the children for the continuation of their education after the COVID. Now they should have the plan. These many children in my panchayat need this support so that they will be able to continue the education. So they need to develop the plan. And monetary support definitely should be given to the week, or they have to link them with government schemes. I'm not suggesting housing. There are other things like, you know, NAREGA, 100 days work, you know, employment guarantee program, that they can link it up. And livelihood schemes, they have the National Skill Development Mission, they can identify and the required skills can be imparted to them through training, then this can be done. And I always suggest, to prevent them from the economic shock, they need to be covered with the social insurance. Already there are two very good schemes. For 12 rupees, it will be deducted from your bank, you will get 2 lakhs, up to 2 lakhs accident death insurance, right? The second scheme is around 330. So if you pay 330 every year, even if it is a natural death up to 55 years, they'll give 2 lakhs. So if a person covers under this scheme, you know, the breadwinner dies, then definitely they'll get this kind of thing. And just quote one example, the migrants died in the train accident. If they are covered under these schemes, the family would have got 4 lakh rupees. Accident death and for death, you know, any death, they get the scheme. So they will not be in the economic shock. They can bear to some more time, for some more time. Then registering the workers in the welfare boards. So most of the people in unorganized sector, even not even 50% of them are registered with the welfare boards. The registration process should be facilitated. The e-governance should be improved. Efficiency should be improved, right? It should be made mandatory that all the unorganized workers should be registered in the particular board, concerned board. That has to be done. Then in Tamil Nadu, already they have state balanced growth fund. In 105 blocks have been identified as backward blocks based on certain criteria, education, health, industrial. So they have certain criteria. So but these blocks, due to their backwardness, the children from these blocks have high vulnerability to be a child laborer. So they need to have a special programs for these children. As earlier said, child development index. Whoever is less than the state average, they have to be given a special program. Maybe in increasing 100 days work to 200 days work will definitely improve the conditions, in the economic conditions of the family, will result in the reduction of the thing. So all these things, you know, need to be done comprehensively so that it will be easier for us to tackle the issue. And it's not only the government's responsibility, as you know, civil societies, trade, other community-based organization, whether it's Rajini Fans Association or any cine association or some kind of traditional structure in the village, whatever, any community-based associations, they can involve and ensure that child labor-free Tamil Nadu.
Thank you.